We are here at the Made by Google event in New York City, where we just got our hands on the brand new Pixel 8 and Pixel 8 Pro smartphones. And while these phones look a lot like last year's models at first glance, there's some really interesting things going on under the hood, including some truly wild AI features. There's a lot to talk about, so let's dive in. These phones look a lot like the Pixel 7 that we got last year, but there have been some changes and refinements to the overall design. Both phones have softer edges that are a bit more curved, a bit easier to hold, and in what's my favorite change, the Pixel 8 Pro now has a matte finish. The standard Pixel 8 does still have that glossy design. Subtle refinements, but they do look and feel a little bit better than last year's. Now, Google is promising better displays on both of these phones. The standard Pixel 8 sports an Actua display. The Pixel 8 Pro sports what Google's calling a Super Actua display. It's another new marketing term, but what you really need to know is that these phones are designed to be brighter and more accurate. In fact, the Pixel 8 Pro actually boasts a higher brightness rating than the iPhone 15 Pro. Google's Pixel phones are perhaps best known for their cameras. Now on paper, the specs are fairly similar compared to the Pixel 7. You will get a better ultra-wide lens on the 8 Pro. The standard Pixel 8 finally gets macro mode, but as with any Google device, it's really about the software and what's going on under the hood. So we'll start with the Magic Editor. You can take a photo, hop into the Magic Editor, and freely move and resize whatever people and objects you want to alter in that shot. So we've got this lovely picture of me just hanging out right here at the Made by Google event. All right, I'm just gonna tap myself, and then we're gonna drag me over closer to the devices so I could play with all these lovely new phones and watches. And now we just wait for it to process. This phone is powered by the new Tensor G3 chip, which allows the new Pixels to do this kind of really advanced photo editing pretty much on the fly. You still do have to wait a little bit, but considering what we just did, that was pretty fast. Now, the picture that I came up with was very obviously edited. I don't think it's gonna fool anyone, but I think people are gonna find some creative ways to use this tool, and very excited to see how it ends up being utilized. We also got to try out Best Take, which is probably my favorite thing about the Pixel 8 range so far. So as long as you've taken at least two group photos, your phone will run through all of them and let you change each person's face on a person-by-person basis. It's really trippy to see in action, to just see one person's face change while the others remain static. It's a little Black Mirror-y, a little creepy, but it's also very practical. Now, we also got to try out a number of AI-powered features. One of those was Call Screen. So Call Screen's been around on Pixel phones for a while. Not only is it designed to filter out even more spam calls, which is great, but it will soon allow you to just send contextual replies to a call via text.
It's a simple task. We contextually pick up on that and can provide you with auto replies.
So this is the CNN underscore dental office, and we just wanted to confirm your appointment for today.
Thanks for calling. They said they'll call you back to reschedule.
You know, what we're taking are these simple tasks that shouldn't be as painful as having to pick up your phone, and we're really letting you automate them with one tap.
So we're checking out the new temperature sensor. So we've got an ice cold glass of water and a hot cup of coffee, and we're gonna see how well this phone detects the temperature of each one. So to do that, you're just gonna open up the thermometer app, and there are actually a variety of presets. We're gonna go with the beverages and water one. So let's start with some water. You wanna get about 2 inches away from whatever the surface is. So it's picking up about 65, 66 degrees for the water. Move over to the coffee. And we're at about 80 or so. This could be a nice little assistant, something I'd like to use when I'm at home cooking. The Google Pixel 8 range is available right now. The Pixel 8 is starting at $699, and the Pixel 8 Pro will start at $999. It's worth noting that these phones are $100 more expensive than last year's models, but Google is promising a lot in terms of software, and it is really designing these phones to be built to last. In fact, for the first time, these phones will get software and security updates for 7 years, which is the longest we've ever seen on a Pixel phone. So if you do buy one of these, know that you will get the latest updates for a very long time. As always, we will be putting the Pixel 8 and Pixel 8 Pro through their full paces in our final review, so stay tuned for more.